Hello everyone, welcome back to your favorite channel. Let's see, today we're going to make vegetable Manchurian. There are two processes where we're going to make a vegetable balls first and then we're going to make a vegetable Manchurian sauce. So let's see what we need to make the balls. Let's see the ingredients of what we're going to need for that. For veg Manchurian, what we need today is to make the balls, we need some chopped garlic. We got some chopped ginger. We got some chopped green chilies. We got some spring onion. We got some boiled potato for binding. We got some chopped tricolor pepper. We got some freshly chopped coriander. We got some chopped cabbage. We can add even paneer to that. If you add a paneer, it gives a softness to that Manchurian ball. Then we can add some chopped carrot. And again, egg is an optional option. If you do not eat eggs, you can avoid eggs. You can simply bind it with corn flour. Let's make the veg Manchurian balls. We'll start with the mixture for that. Add a little bit of garlic. Little bit of ginger, a little bit of green chilies, some spring onion, around 2 tablespoons of cabbage, or 1 and 2 tablespoons of carrot, some coriander, one tablespoon of chopped peppers, a little bit of grated potato. Grate the paneer. Season the mixture with some pepper, some salt, a little bit of aromat. Aromat is basically a vegetable stock powder, so you can just mix it up with water and your stock is ready. A little bit of soya sauce, and to finish it off with one tablespoon of corn flour. If it is not really binding, you can even add some eggs to that. And to make it a little thicker, we can add in a little bit of more corn flour. This is just to make sure that your balls, when you try to fry it up in the oil, it should not break off. And your bowl mixtures are ready. Okay, now let's deep fry the Manchurian balls. What we have today is a fryer. If you do not have a household fryer, you can even use your kadai for frying. For balls, you can even choose to make it a little smaller, a little bigger, as per your choice. So it depends on you whether you want to have it in a little larger size or a little smaller size. Almost ready with the balls. You can see it is getting nice golden brown. So let it get cooked fully, and here is our nice golden brown veg Manchurian balls are ready. And now let's go, we're going to make some sauce for Manchurian. For that we need some wok, a little bit of oil. Make sure you season your wok so that it doesn't stick anything to that. Let's go on adding the things. Chopped garlic, chopped ginger. Fry a little bit. A little bit of chopped carrots, a little bit of chopped cabbage, chopped green chilies. We can use the same ingredients what we made with a sauce. Except the potatoes and the paneer. We added some chopped peppers. Some chopped spring onions. When the vegetables are done, it's almost like half cooked. You can drop in a glass of water for the sauce. Once the water starts a little boiling, you can start adding up the sauces to that. A little bit of vinegar. Then you add a little soy sauce. You add a little bit of aromat. Add a little bit of salt, because your aromat and your soy sauce will both have a little salt inside. Add a little pepper. Let it get boiled. Then I have this mixture ready of corn flour. Once your sauce is ready, it's time to drop in your manchurian balls, what we made earlier. Let it simmer. Drop in some fresh coriander. Manchurians are always finished with coriander. And your veg manchurian is ready to serve. Garnish it with a little bit of fresh coriander. And you can have your veg manchurian with even freshly steamed rice, or even a fried rice, or even veg hakka noodles.